Hey everyone, it's Mushtaq here, and in this video we are gonna take a look at 100 Excel tips and tricks. These tips and tricks make you more productive and advanced user of Excel. As they are not in particular order, so be sure to watch the video till end. If you have any question, you can ask in comments. Take a moment, hit thumbs up button and subscribe to channel for future Excel videos. Now let's get started. Set date default format in Excel. We have one table here, and in this table we have one column entry date, and entry date we can see there are few dates are there. So if I'm entering one more date 02-March 2020, it will automatically convert into another format 3/2/20. Now I want to make the default format for my Excel. Every time I will enter the date, it will convert automatically into the default format. Instead of, I will right click here and change the format cell. Just go to control panel, time and language, additional date, time and regional setting. Then change date, time or number formats. Then again additional settings and date. So here you can give your required format in the short date dd-mm-yyyy and click apply. Okay, close the windows. So format by default format has been changed. Now I am gonna enter one more date 01/Jan/2019, so automatically the format is set to 01-01. In Windows 7, you can do by going to control panel, then region and language. Step 1, click here, then additional setting. Step 2, step 3, click on date tab, and in step 4, you can set the format here and then click OK.
Alternative to merge and center. Center heading without merge. How can we do this? This is our table and we give name to this table. Pass list of 2020. Now select all the columns of first row. Right click, format cell. And in horizontal option, just select the center across selection. So you can see we did not merge the cells and we centered a heading. Create auto update table in Excel. How can we do that? Just select the table and press Ctrl T. Create table. Click OK. This is auto update table is created in Excel. Whenever you will enter the any column, system will automatically update the record. Suppose we enter product 6, 400, 5. So you can see this calculated column is automatically calculated. Add selection of formula automatically at the end of sheet table. How can we do this? Just click on the last row of the table. Click enter equal. Give the reference of the last row. So you can see all formulas are added automatically. If you want to count total 6 products, what is the maximum value of unit price 550, minimum quantity 1, and sum of total 6650. So you can automatically select the formula here. Flash fill. Flash fill is one of the good options in Excel when you want to fill the column based on the pattern. So here we want the agent name from his email. So let's type first name John Davis and press Ctrl E from keyboard. So here Excel automatically fill the rest of the cells. This is one option. Another option, you can click just corner of the cell with mouse, right click, drag to the last cell and leave the mouse. You will see the one options also coming here. Flash fill. Let's see one more example. Suppose this is product and this is 100 unit price. You want to join them. Just click here. Product 1, 100 and Control E. So you can see there. All other cells automatically join based on the pattern. Auto sum. If you want to sum any of the column, just click after last cell and then press Alt and equal from the keyboard. So you can see this cell has automatically updated the total value.
If function in Excel. If is one of Excel's most used function. If is a logical function which returns one value if a condition is true or another value if condition is false. It has basically three parts. First one is logic. If logic is correct, then execute the second part. If logic is false, then execute the third part. Now we will apply this formula here to calculate commission based on the total sale. If total sale is more than 1000, then commission is 20%. If it is less than or equal to 1000, then commission is 10%. So double click here, enter equal, if bracket D3 reference of total sale less than and equal to 1000. If it is less than or equal to 1000, then comma again. Now two condition, so total sale multiply 0.1 means 10%, then comma again total sale multiply 0.2 bracket close. So if the condition is true, it will execute and multiply the total sale with 10% to calculate the 10% commission. If fails, then it will multiply total sale with 0.2 to calculate the 20%. Enter and drag to last row. So here's the commission is calculated. First one sale is less than 1000, so commission is 10%, which is 20. In second case, it is more than 1000, so commission is 20%, which is 300. And here equal to 1000, so again 10% commission. If you want to display the actual percentage, how much is the percentage, then you can also do how, just edit the formula and in second part, which is true, just replace with inverted comma 10%, inverted comma close, and the second part 20% inverted comma close. So this is how you can do. Enter and drag to last row. So 10%, 20%, 10%, 20%. If you will change the value, it will automatically change the commission. Logical functions in Excel. AND, OR. Logical functions return either true or false value when their conditions are checked. In OR formula, if any one condition is true, then formula will return true. But in AND formula, all conditions must be true, then formula will return true. So we are gonna calculate commission based on total sale and entry date. If total sale is more than 1000 or entry date is after 1st January 2020, then commission is 20%, else commission is 10%. So equal, if, then OR formula, first condition D3, give the reference greater than equal to 1000 comma, then E3 date greater than equal to, we gonna give the date in Excel. We have to use the date for function 2020-01-01 bracket close. So now we will close the bracket of OR formula, comma. What is the true answer as per if formula? Commission is 20%. Inverted comma close, then comma, then again inverted comma, 10%. Inverted comma close, and then close the bracket of if and press enter. Drag to last cell. So here it is 20% because first condition is failed, but second condition is true. The result will come as a true. True means 20%. Here both conditions are true. Here first condition is failed, but second condition is true. Here both conditions are true, and here both conditions are failed. How? Because date is also not greater than 2020, 1st January, and total sale is also less than 1000. So both conditions are failed. So result is failed. If we will change the commission total sale here, so automatically this commission is become 10% because one condition already was failed and total sale is also less than 1000. Now we will apply the same formula here but with AND formula. If AND T3 greater than equal to 1000 and E3 greater than equal to date 2020-01-01 bracket close and bracket close of AND formula, comma, and inverted comma 20%, inverted comma close, then comma, inverted comma 10%, and then close the bracket of if formula. Drag to last cell. So here it is 10% because first condition is failed, second is true, but first is failed. So in AND, if any one condition is failed, then false statement will be executed of if formula. Here it is 20% because both conditions are true. It is more than 1000 and it is the date is after 1st January 2020. Again here total sale is this condition is fail, and here sale is more than 1000 but the date is before or earlier than 1st January 2020, so second condition is failed. If any one condition is failed, then 10%. So this is how AND and OR formula works in Excel. Nested if function. The if function is a built-in function in Excel, but when we use if function as a part of formula, then that is called nested. It is possible to nest multiple if functions within one Excel formula. This is simple if function. Logic is true, then execute second part. If logic is false, then execute third part. Nested if means if logic is true, then execute second part, but if logic is false, then another if formula instead of the false statement. So here we gonna apply the if formula based on total sale to calculate commission of different categories. If total sale B3 greater than equal to 1500 comma, then commission is inverted comma 40%, inverted comma close, then comma, then inverted comma, new formula here. So instead of new if function, I'm just typing new formula here and then enter. Just drag to last cell. So here it is 40%, 40%, 40%. Why? It is equal to 1500. And here this is more than 1500, both values. So 40%. Now copy this formula. Control C. Paste here. Again, because we are going to apply three nested functions. So B3, if it is more than 1000, then 30%. If it is more than equal to 500, then 20%. And if it is more than 200, 10%. If fails, then 0 commission. So this is last one. Here we will not apply the formula after this, so I'm just giving the false statement of the last nested if function. Now copy this and paste. So new formula here, just remove the text with inverted comma. After this comma, in the value if false, copy, paste the formula here, enter. So check the results. So new 30% coming because sale is 1000. 1000 means 30%. Now next one, control C, again paste in the same place, new formula. We are going to apply 4 nested if functions. Enter. 20% because it is more than 500. Then the last one, control C, and remove this and enter. Okay, so here it is 10% because sale is equal to 200. It is executing this part in first place. This is fail, so not 40%. Check the another if. This is fail, not 30%. Check another if, false. This is fail, and this is okay. It's equal to 200 total sales, so 10%. In the zero case, every condition getting failed, so in the last it is giving the last statement. If false, then they execute this, the last one, zero. So this is how you can add multiple nested if functions within the one if function.
Errors handling in Excel formula. If any formula in Excel gives error, then value can be replaced with another value. Let's have a look handling error formula. It has two options. First one is formula, and the second one is value if first parts fail. Now we will apply this formula while calculating the unit price. So total sale divided by quantity to calculate the unit price. Drag this formula till end. So it gives us the error here, division error. So now we will apply the formula from start. If error, then bracket. So this is the first formula or logic here, then comma. What if our formula fails, gives any error? So in inverted comma we can say quantity missing. So you can see quantity missing is coming here. If you enter the quantity, it will give us the proper value. Or if you will remove the quantity from any row, then it will automatically adjust the formula. So if, instead of quantity, if you want to display any value, you can display like zero. Copy text or formula on clipboard for later use. In Excel, if you want to copy text or formula and want to use them again and again, you can achieve this by clipboard. Instead, we open a notepad to do this. This will save lots of time. So first, open the clipboard. Click here on the options. You have to click here, show office clipboard when control C, press twice. Here it is already clicked in my book. but if it is unchecked, you have to check it. Now, first we will copy this first column, Control C, we will press twice, so it is already copied here. Then second column, one time you can copy because this window only opens when you press twice, but it's already open. Then quantity, sale, and we also want to copy our formula, big formula, Control C. So everything we have copied after selection from keyboard after pressing the Control C command. Then we will go to another sheet, and here we want to paste all those commands. So just in new notebook, new sheet, click on clipboard, whatever you want to paste, just click product. In next column we want to paste quantity, then unit price. We can calculate total or we can paste from here. And this is the formula. If you want to use the formula for any other purpose, you can use the formula from clipboard as well. Convert all the formulas into values. If you want to convert your formulas into values, then just select the formula. We have formula in this column, you can see. So just select all the cells, copy from keyboard, Control C, right click, copy, and then again right click. You will see here values, this option is coming, or you can go to the paste special values. If you are using any other version of Excel, then you have to go to the paste special and just click on the values. So you can see there, now it's no more any formula, just value. Select and delete all formatting or comments at once. In this table, we have few comments and also some formatting. Let's see how can we clear this all. Comments are here, here and here. Some cells have background color and also it's bold and big font. So first we will clear the comments, select the table, home, editing, and clear. So clear the comments, we can see all comments have been cleared. Now if you want to clear the formatting, you can also do from here, format. Or if you have any hyperlinks or anything in your Excel sheet, you can clear from here. Clear all hyperlinks, all comments, formatting and everything. Use Control plus Enter to fill an entire range. Very useful tips when we are working on the large Excel files. Here we want to calculate the total sale by multiplying unit price into quantity. So first select the total sale column. Now press equal. Give the reference of the unit price and quantity B3 into C3. Now from the keyboard just press Control Enter. So have you noticed the entire range is automatically filled. Protect the sheet but only allow entry in limited cells. It's very useful trick. Sometimes we require data entry in Excel sheets from other users and also want to protect our auto-calculated columns or complex formulas. Now in this sheet I will tell you how can we do this. We have two columns where formula is calculating the base on other columns here in column D and in commission. So first we can highlight these two columns just to show the user this is protected column. We can make it color. Now in the second step, we will go to the review tab and we will select the ranges where we want to allow the entry for other users. So allow users to edit the ranges. Click new and here click the range. So press the control button from keyboard and select the ranges. You can select these three ranges and these two. So here you can see I have selected the all ranges. I will show you again. Select this and this. Keep pressing control key. Okay, don't leave the control key. Keep pressing and then select the cells where you want to allow the entry. Okay. Apply. Okay. Now in next step, protect the sheet. Click here, protect, and you can give any password. Just now I'll give the password 1 from the keyboard. Okay. Re-enter password. Okay. Now let's see. Can we enter the data here? No. Everything is protected. Only here we can remove and we can ask user to give us the data. If they want to give us the new information, they can only give here. Product 10, unit price 10, quantity 20, entry date today, entry name John. So no commission. But if you will increase the quantity or unit price, commission is automatically calculated. So in other cells, nobody can enter the data because everything is protected. Toggle between open Excel books. If you will press Alt plus Tab key from the keyboard, you will see, you can see all the windows which are open in your machine. Document, Book 3, Book 2, Book 1. But if you want to switch between only within the Excel books, you can press from the keyboard Control Shift plus Tab. So now you can see Book 1. Then I'm keep pressing the Control Shift and then Tab. Book 2, Book 3. Book 1, Book 2, Book 3. And if you want to switch between only two books, no need to press Shift key, just Control Tab. Now Book 1, Book 3. Allow data entry only when the previous cell is filled. Sometimes we do not allow a user to enter data in one column if condition of another column does not meet. Look at this table. Sold quantity must not be entered if unit price is missing. How can we do this? Let's see. Go to data, first select the cell, then go to data, in the data tools, then data validation. Here allow, in allow you have to enter the custom formula equal not is blank with cell B, this one B3, bracket close, and remove the check from here, ignore blank. Now drag the formula till last cell, so it will apply it on all cells. Let's enter the quantity here, 10, 20, 30, 40. This value doesn't match the validation restrictions. because unit price is missing, so we cannot enter the quantity here. Next one is 30. 30, we can also cannot enter here. 50 and 100, 200. So if value is missing in the unit price, we cannot enter the sold quantity. Create your own error message in data validation. We have one validation already in place in this column C, sold quantity should not be allowed if unit price is missing. So let's try 10. This value doesn't match the data validation, but what kind of validation? So we can create our own message which will give us the clear information of the error. Select the cell, go to data tools, then data validation, error alert. In the error alert, first give the title, unit price error. Please maintain unit price in order to enter sold quantity. Okay, drag this to last cell. Now enter the quantity here. You can see unit price error. Please maintain unit price in order to enter sold quantity. Cancel. We maintain the unit price first and then we enter the quantity. Display a message when cell is selected. How can we do this? If you want to display any message when any cell is selected, you can do this by data validation, and then input message. So whenever I will click the sold quantity cell, I want to have the input message. Unit price must be maintained for this product. So whenever I will select the cell, system will give me this warning message. Only date or number allow in the cell. This is one of the good options if you are working on large data set and do not want to have any garbage in the number or date columns. So how can we do this? We have one column C, sold quantity, and this is supposed to be the number format, and we have one more column F, entry date, so the date should be entered here. Right now I can enter any text here, any text in the entry date as well. Excel will not stop me to enter any text here. I only want to have the number format or number entry option here and date option in the F column. So click on the cell, go to data validation, data validation, enter data validation, go to setting, and here allow the whole number or decimal number, whatever you want, sold quantity. We click all the whole number, and we can also give the range, ignore blank, minimum range. Obviously sold quantity could be zero, and maximum we can give 1000 just for testing. Okay, drag this column to till last cell. Now here go to entry date. Again, data validation, and select date. Start date 01/01/2020, and end is 31st December 12, 2020. Okay. Also drag this to last cell. Now we will try to enter any other information here. So it is not allowing us any date here. Only you can enter the number, but we just have selected the whole number, so even the decimal will not allow here. And also if you will enter the 1000, more than 1000 value, it will not allow you. So we have to be within 1000, whatever our range is there. Now go to the date column and try to enter the text first. It is not allowing any number. No. Okay, enter the date. Fine. Now we enter the date from the last year. No, we cannot. Next year, we cannot. So this is how data validation works with the date and number format. Select cell value only from list. In Excel, if you want to restrict data entry other than specific value list, it is possible through data validation list. We have here one column, column E, where we need to restrict the agent name based on these values. Now, right now we can type anything here. So now if you want to restrict, just select the cell, go to data, data validation, list, ignore blank, click here and give the source, means range of list. So and then click OK and apply to all cells. Drag to last row. Now we cannot type anything here. We can only select from the list. If you want to hide these values, just cut and control right key and then paste here. You can also change the color. So now it is hidden and user cannot see. User can only select from the values. Move rows and columns without cut paste. This how can we do? Just click on the shift key from the keyboard and left mouse key. So if you want to move any column, click the column, press the shift button and just click on the border of this column on the top and move wherever you want to move. Any other column if we want to move. Without shift, if you will try to move this column, then it will just give you the message that there are data you want to replace it. So it will update the data and remove the existing column. So if you want to keep the existing column, you have to press the shift key from the keyboard. Multiply, divide with a number using paste special. How can we do this? Suppose we have here total 1 month sale and we want to convert into the 12 months. Just click here 12, copy, select the values, right click, paste special, multiply. So all values have been multiplied with the 12. You can see. In same way, if you want to divide, just click Ctrl C, right click, paste special and divide. So now it is divided by 12. Select visible cells only. You can see we have one table here, and first I will hide few cells here. Now I want to copy this table and paste on another sheet. So have you seen, even the hide, whatever cells were hide, those are also copied here. So we will go again here and select the table, go to home, find and select, then go to special visible cells only, click OK. This option you can also call from the keyboard, Control G. Special visible cells only. Now copy, Control C, go to another book, add the sheet and paste here. So now the hidden rows are not copied here, only the visible cells or rows are copied from this file. Make a copy of worksheet. How can we make the copy? Just go to your sheet, right click, move or copy, create a copy. This is one method. Another one, press the control key from keyboard and just click on the sheet and drag to the position where you want to copy another sheet. So you can see I'm keep pressing the control button and then I'm just dragging the sheet. So this is the fastest method to create the copy of sheet. Angle cell text to make columns with narrow. If we have a very large data sheet and too many columns and we want to make the width of the columns narrow, so how can we do this? Just click on your column, Control 1 from keyboard, and then just change the angle. We change the angle to 90, and then you can reduce the width of the columns. Quantity, unit price, code. You can also right click and go to the format cell. The same option is also here. Join the contents of two or more cells. If you want to join two cells, you can use the concatenate formula. Press equal in the cell agent name because we want to join the column E and F, first and second name here. Concatenate. Then give the reference of the first cell, E3, comma, then inverted comma, space, inverted comma, comma, then third text means second name. So we have also include the space between two, first and second name. Enter. Just drag to the last cell. This is one method. Another method, if you don't want to use the concatenate formula, just press equal, first name, AND operator, inverted comma, space, AND operator, second name. This is the another method. You can join the two text of two cells. Convert date to quarter. We have date here, so first we will check what is the month of this date. Month. Okay, now we have the month and we know in one quarter we have 3 months, so let's divide this with 3. Okay, now we have the value of each quarter. So but what is the quarter? So we will do round up function. We will do the round out because we want to go to the up
level? I mean, like 1 to 3 month or 4 to 6 month. This is a format of round function. First give the value and then how many decimal places. We want 0 decimal places. And then, so now we want to move these decimal places and we want to hide them. So just now this is the quarter of each month. 1 1, this is second quarter, fourth quarter. But we also can see this quarter is from the last year and this quarter is from the 2018. So how can we know this is a quarter of which month? We know the formula. This is our formula. We will concatenate the year with this formula. How can we do this? First, add Q here in the inverted comma. Q and operator. So now we have the quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 4, and then click again or F2 in the last and operator again. Then year formula and give the value of cell G3 bracket close. There again. Q1 2020, still if you want to make a space or dash between quarter value and the year value, you can do this here. Add one more and operator and here give the dash. Quarter one, remove the zero, sorry. Quarter one 2020, 2080, and this is quarter four of 2019. Right click menu. There's a right click drop down menu in Excel, but many of the users are not aware about this one. How can we use this one? Just select any column. And on the border, just hold with mouse and drag to any other location. You will see you can move here, copy as a values only, shift down and copy. There are many options are there. Just copy here. So we have seen we can copy this one. Format painter. Format painter will be mostly used when we want to apply the existing format on another cells. Suppose we have one cell here, product. We want to change the background color, bold, and then font size 18. Now we want to apply the same format on the other cells. Just click here. Click on the format painter. You will see the brush is coming. Apply the brush on the other cells. Now I want to change the format of this one. Table, lines, bold, and font size 12. Now I want to apply the same format on other cells. So I can do this by format painter. Formula should not change while adding rows or columns. We have simple table here. We just copy the next month data, month of February from the another sheet. Here, copy. And add here. So still it's not updating. We can see 65 C2 to C2. Okay, let's move. And change. Now we will go again next month. Copy and this. So again C2 D2. Every time we have to do this B2. Instead of this one, we can use indirect formula. Indirect and an inverted comma, we can say B2, comma close, bracket close. So now it's 144, and you can see here we give the reference. Reference mean now whenever we will add the row, the B2 will remain same because we are giving the indirect reference. Now copy the April data
B2 is there. Copy my data. So you can see same way we can use in the row, or if you want to give the reference of any another sheet, another workbook, you can use the indirect formula if you want to fix the actual reference, actual cell number. Insert current date time in Excel. There are two formulas. One is today, which will only insert the date, and another one with time. So you can insert current date time in your Excel book with these two formulas. Please keep in mind, whenever you will open the Excel book, this will automatically refresh and it will always show you the current date time. Remove grid lines or change grid lines color from a sheet. For this, you have to go to File, Options, Advanced, then come down, Display options for this worksheet here. Show grid lines is here. First, we will change the color. Change the color to green. You can see the grid lines color change. And if you want to remove the grid lines, then you can go to Page Layout and you can also click here. Change sheet name and display color. How can we do this? Just click, right click of any sheet, rename. Learning Hub. Now if you want to change the color, click here. And go to on tab color and change the color. So we select the green color. Hide and show sheets. This is one of the another option when you want to hide your sheets from someone else, or if you want to show only limited sheets in the front in your book, just right click on sheet name and click hide. So here you can hide it. Now if you want to bring the hided sheet, just click on unhide. So here we can click again on the sheet we hide it, sheet one, and now it's back. Quick analysis in Excel. One of the good option in Excel, if you want to analyze your sheet immediately after entering the data, just select the column. You will see one option is coming here, quick analysis. Click here. Color based on some logics, data bar. 234 is the highest number, so others are a short number. We just test this one first. Now it is 77. If you will do 200, so it will automatically, the color will move forward. Zero means nothing. More options. If you want to see the total of sold quantity sum, this is done. Else count 12. Here you can also do average count, total sum. So this is useful tool if you want to immediately analyze your Excel data. Split single Excel file in multiple windows. This is again one of the very good trick. If you want to work in multiple Excel sheets, and if you want to move from one sheet to another to copy the data or see the result, you can use this function. So go to view, window and new window. So when I will open the new window, it will open one new workbook with two number. Then again, view, workbook number 3. So now with same name, Learning Hub 1, Learning Hub 2, Learning Hub 3, I have 3 books. And if I will change anything in this book, suppose I will make total, then I'll change the color. Now I will go to book 2. The same changes are applied here. Here as well. Now here I want to work in the sheet 2. Okay, I can work here in the sheet 2. I can see, oh, these are the total products. And I can go to another sheet with control tab. And I can see, okay, this is the product. So I can move between two sheets. One workbook and two different sheets. And whenever I have done my work, I can close this one, this one. So this is the remaining last file book. And when I will close this one, it will ask me to if I want to save it or no. This is one of the good feature of Excel. If you want to work in your Excel sheet, but if you want to work in the different windows, you can use this functionality. Freeze pen to always display header. While working on large Excel sheets, sometimes if you want to see the header to know about what is the column where we are entering the data. So this is another sheet where we want to freeze this first column. So go to view, freeze pen, and freeze drop row. Now if I will move the mouse cursor to down, I can see I am on the 73 record, but still I can see the header. Now if I will move to the right side, the first column serial number is missing or it is being hidden on the left side. So now I want to see this column as well while going to the right side. What I can do, I first unfreeze pen because the top row was already freezed, and click on B2. Click on B2 and then go to again freeze pen. Now first row as well as the first column both have been freezed. Now if I will go to the right side, I can see serial number is freeze. Now if I will go to the bottom of the Excel, again it is freeze. If you want to freeze the second column, just unfreeze the pen, click on C2 and freeze the pen. So now first header is freezed, and if I will go to the right side, both first and second column also have been freezed. Split worksheet into windows. Sometimes while working on the large sheets, we want to compare the data within one sheet. So we can do this by split the worksheet into the windows. So go to view. In the view, you have the option split. So just click split. Now our sheet has been split. We can, if you want to work on the four windows, it's okay, but I want to work on the two windows. So I will just click, I will remove this vertical line, click on the line and double click from the mouse. So it will be removed. Now this is window one, we can call it, or window two, two windows are there. In this window, we go to the record 20. Just highlight, and in this window we go to the record 60, from 60. So if you want to compare your data, or if you want to work in any other way, you can do it by splitting your sheet into the windows. and then you can compare or you can analyze your data. How to repeat the top row in the print? We have one sheet, and if you want to print, we can see the top row is coming on the first page. Let's go to the second page. Here it is not coming. On the third page, it's not coming. So if we want to print this row on every page, just go to the page layout, page setup, sheet, rows to repeat at top. Click here and select the first row. You can select as many as rows you want. Select the first row and click OK. Now go to again file, print, first page, second page, third page. Sorting days and month. By default, Excel sort in the alphabetic order. Suppose we have the month here, data, sort by A to Z. So April is coming on the first. We have days here. F is coming on the top, W on the last. So if you want to sort in the month order, or if you want to sort in the days order, we have one option here in the Excel. Go to sort, select the column month, then go to custom list. In custom list, you have already few lists. Click on this list and select OK. So it is sorted in the month's order. Now go to days and then select custom list here. Okay. Days are sorted in Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Create custom sorting criteria in Excel. In this sheet, we have one column, priority. Now we want to sort it. High is coming on the top and very low, and very high is coming in between. So if you want to have one more sorting criteria, we can create our own sorting criteria. How? Go to file, options, advanced, come down, edit custom list. So we want to add one sorting criteria. First is very high, high, medium, low, very low, and add it. Okay. So now if you want to sort this one, click on the sort button, priority, custom list, and okay. So very high is coming on the top and very low. This is added permanently, so whenever you want to use in the future, you can use it. No need to create this sorting criteria again and again. Perform multi-level sorting. If you want to sort a sheet based on more than one column, it is called multi-level sorting. We have one column, products, month, so we want to sort it based on the product and then month. So click on the sort option in data view, then click first column, product, add another level from here, and the second level is month. But we know that for month we cannot sort alphabetical wise, so we have to select the custom list. Okay, custom list, and then click OK. So first one is product one, January, then May, July, and December, then product two, January. So it is sorted based on two column. If you want to sort on another column, you can add total sale, large to smallest. So in January, we have 209,000, then we have 147,000, then we have 137,000. Filter top 10 records. Sometimes for data analysis or for forecast, we want to know that what are the top 10 products or top 10 sales agent in different ways we want to analyze the data. So suppose we want to see what are the top sales based on the single records, we can go to data filter. In filter, you can click here top 10 records. So if you will click on the top 10 records, system will automatically display only top 10 records here based on the total sale. Create summary with pivot table. Pivot table, one of the good feature of Excel. If you want to summarize your data and you want to analyze your data, you can use the pivot option. With pivot option, we can summarize large volume of data into the small tables. Here we have one table which is containing the sales information. So just go to insert, click on the pivot table. This will automatically select the range, but if you want to change the range, you can click here and change the range. And if you want to copy this pivot table in somewhere in the location, you know, just click here and give the location, I mean another sheet reference. But we want to create the new sheet, so we will click on the new sheet and automatically the new sheet will be created. Here we can display the fields in pivot area, and here we can copy the column based on how we want to see our information. So we want to see products here in the rows. Every product will come up in the row. And then we want to see how much is total sale. So total sale copy in the values. Now we also want to see how much total unit we have sold. So just click on the total unit and drag in the values. Okay, product one, this much units are sold and this is the total sale for full year. And then we want to see how much is total number of lines. So just click on the product and drag here. You can see the count is automatically coming. Product 1 have been sold 14 times, 5 times, 10 times, product 4, so on. And if you want to change anything, you can change here. Value, field setting, maximum, minimum, whatever you want to do. So suppose we want to see how much total units sold as a maximum, we will click here, field setting, maximum. So maximum for product 1 is 88, for product 2 is 96, product 3 is 98 again. We can also remove this if you want to remove. And next, we want to see total sale agent wise. So we will click on the sale agent and drag into the columns. So this is the grand total is coming for product 1. And agent wise, sale agent wise, we can also see the summary for each agent. This is almost 609,000 for 478,000, 278,000 plus. So for every sale agent, we can also see the summary. Create unique or distinct count in pivot table. We have one sheet here. Let's insert the pivot table for this sheet. Pivot table. It will automatically select the range. And new sheet is okay. Now we have to click on this checkbox, add this data to the data model, because if we will not click here, we will not have the unique count option. Click OK. Now first we will see products, how many total products are there. So drag the product here, 73 lines. Now we want to see, remove the product, and for account For this account number, we have 28 times, 15 times, 19. But I want to see the unique. I mean, there may be one product is coming one or twice or three or four times. But I want to know in this account how many total products are linked. So instead of count, I will use the distinct count. Okay, for this account, we have 8 products linked. For this account, we have 5 products linked. For this account, 7. And for this account, we have 1 product only. Filter, view, and ranking in pivot table. Filter. First, we will use this filter option. Suppose if you want to filter product based on the sales agent, just move the sales agent column into the filter box and select here which sales agents you want to see. So we want to see Ben, Gary, and John only. So now we have the summary of these products only for these three sales agents. Now next, we want to also display this sales agent. But this format is coming as a outline and we want to see these products in another column. So how can we do this? Just right click pivot table options, display, and click on the classic pivot table layout. Now through this option we can see products are coming in the different column. We can copy this data somewhere else and also merge these cells. Now the next one is how can we rank these products for these sales agent. What is the first product, what is the second product from ranking point of view. So just click on the total button here, right click and go to show value as largest to smallest. So you can see this is the first in the ranking from count or unit sold point of view. You can also view total units sold, 186, just sort it, 186, second 173, product 2, on third rank 144 units sold for product 7, then product 3 on the fourth number 101 units have been sold. This is only for Ben. Then the same ranking is for Gary and same ranking is for John. If you want to see the ranking from sales point of view, then just remove the sales agent. Now this ranking coming as a product 5 have been sold, almost 659 units sold for product 5. Then 609 units sold for product 2, which is on second in the list. Create your own calculated field in pivot table. We have one sheet here. Let's insert pivot table first. New sheet. Add the product in rows and total units sold in values. So for product 1, total units are 596 in 12 months for full year. For product 2, 609. Now we want to know what is the average unit sold per month. So what we will do, go to analyze, field, items and sets, calculated field, unit sold per month. First we have to give the name, then click on total unit sold and divide by 12. Add and then click OK. So just change the format of number. So this is the average. Almost 15 unit sold, 4 product 1 per month, 4 product 251, 4 product 8 only 1. So this is how we can create the calculated feed in pivot table. Aging or range analysis. Aging or range analysis we can also do with the pivot table. In our example, we have some sales information here. Now first we will add the pivot table. Insert pivot table, click OK, new sheet, and then we want to do analysis, range analysis based on the unit sold. So just click on the unit sold, also move this to rows and change the calculation type from sum to count here. Now come to table, display table, right click here, grouping. We will do the group with start from 0 and at 100 and increment by 15. So 0 to 14 units have been sold 14 times. 30 to 44 units have been sold 13 times. 60 to 74 units have been sold 5 times. And 90 to 104 units have been sold 5 times. So total number of times 73, and this is how we can do analysis. Insert a chart for table. We already have summarized information of our detailed sale here with through pivot table. So let's first change the heading. Product name, total units sold in year, and then select any of the cell and go to insert recommended charts. You have many options, whatever you want to use type of chart you can use, but we will use the simple bar chart. Just double click. You can change the size of chart as well. Now click off any of the bar and just add the label, so it will show us the value of total sold. So this is how you can insert the chart in Excel. Chart formatting. How can we do the chart formatting? Let's add one chart here. Select this data first and go to insert recommended chart and select the bar chart. You can also select any other option you want. Okay, then we will change the first bar color. Double click on any of the bars, so automatically the window will open on the right side here. So fill, then solid fill. In the solid fill you can change the color, any of the color. Okay, then we also want to reduce the width between these bars. Click series option and then make it 50. Seems okay. Now click on any bar and right click and add the labels. Okay, font size seems very small, so make it larger. Little small. Now, if you want to remove these grid lines, just double click. No lines. Okay. Then this heading. Okay. Background of this quarter one, quarter two. Okay. Fill color. Fine. So this is how we can change the formatting of charts based on different color. If you want to change the series, then click here on vertical series and then click on axis options again, and here you can set the maximum number, maximum value. We will make it 1000 instead of 900, 0 to 1000. Okay, this is one of the method you can change the formatting. And you can also, if you will double click, so you will see after double click there are different designs are coming on the top of window. You can select any of the design to change the formatting if you want. So we select this design, and also there are quick layouts for the charts here. Suppose you want to see the value below, what are the Q1 value, Q2 value, you can also select. So Q1 822, Q4 822, this is one of the another option to change the layout of the chart. 3D charts in Excel. We have quarterly sale information here. Just select this, go to insert, recommended chart, all charts, and then click on the 3D chart. If you want to click the pie chart, everywhere you have the 3D option, but we will just click on the bar chart. This is the one of the another format. We will select this simple one. So this is 3D chart. Here different formats are there, you can select whatever format you want. And if you will click right click on the chart, you can see the 3D rotation information. The window will automatically open, and then that percentage wise you can reduce. So if you want to see more, that you can increase. And then X rotation, Y rotation, you can also set from here. Whatever you want to do with this 3D chart, you can adjust. Right click and add labels. Fix the chart size and position. In Excel, if whenever you will change the width of column, if any chart is there below the table, the size of the chart will also change automatically. Let's see how. We have two columns here, so we just change width of column, and did you notice chart size is also changing. And if you will add one column on the left side, chart position will also move to right side. So how can we fix this? First, just properly resize your chart, then double click will open the format area, and click here size and properties. Here you have the option move, but don't size with cells. Don't move or size with cells. So we will select this option, don't move. That's it. Done. Now you can move your columns and you can change the width. The chart will remain on the same position with same size. Go to last cell. This is one of the useful trick if you are working with large volume data set. By using a double click on the edge of cell, you can move to that direction. Suppose we select this cell first. Now I want to move the selection to the right side of the last column. So just come on the corner or edge of the cell. You can see here. So now I will click double click from the mouse. We are now here. The selection jump to the last column. Now if you want to jump to the first column, just click on the left side. Now we moved here. Now if I will want to go to the top, just click on the top side. We moved here. Now if I want to go to the bottom, just click on the bottom edge. Now we moved here. If you don't want to use the mouse, you can also use the direction key with the control key. So just keep pressing control key from the keyboard and press the direction key wherever you want to go. If I will press the top direction key, I will jump to the top row. Now I'm pressing the down key with the control plus down. Now I'm on the last row. Want to go to the right side, so just right direction key press with the control key here. Now press left key with the control key here. Address column width or row height. Here our headings are not appearing completely, so how can we adjust them? Just click on all columns and then click on the edge of the column here. You can click on any column because we have already selected the all columns, so it will adjust to all. But if you want to adjust any one, you can adjust from here. Similar way, if you want to adjust one row, just double click. It will be adjusted according to the font size. And if you want to adjust all the rows, just select them and click on any of the row edge. So it is adjusted. If you want to adjust the full sheet, then just click on the left corner here and then move. Similar way for the columns. Highlight row or column very quickly. There are two options. One is definitely is mouse. You can select the from mouse left click column or row. But another option from keyboard, if you will press shift plus space, it will select the row, or if you will press control space, it will select the column. So wherever you are, if you want to select any column or row, just press. Suppose you want to copy one row, so we will select shift space control C. So this is copied. And if you want to copy the or cut the column, control space. If you will press both control shift plus space, it will select the complete sheet. Delete row or column very quickly. So how can we do this? We have to use two keys. Suppose I want to delete the row, this row first. So one option is I will click from the mouse, right click, delete, and another option from the keyboard. So just press shift plus space to select the row and then control plus minus. So you can see it is selected. That row is deleted and another one is selected. If you want to delete this one, you can also press control plus minus from keyboard. So when again, if you want to delete the next row, control plus minus. Similar way for the column, first I will select the column, control plus space, then control plus minus. Now I want to delete this month, control plus space and then control plus minus. So very quick way to delete the column or rows. Adjust page for printing. Another good trick required for our day-to-day life. So we have one table here and we want to print it. So let's go to File, Print, but it's coming in very different format and also on 6 pages. So let's adjust this first and then we will print. And we can see we have many columns. So first change the orientation. Click on the page setup in the page layout, and instead of portrait, just click on the landscape. So let's go again. Again, few columns are not coming. So another option to adjust the page, this is the one of the good option, go to view, page break, and this blue line, just move, click from the mouse, left mouse key, and move this to the right side end of last column. Now you can see this is page 1 and this is page 2. Now if I will go and see print, now you can see page 1 and page 2. So it is automatically adjusted with the help of page break preview. Remove blank cells from a list. If you have very large sheet and there are some key columns have blank cells and you want to get rid of those cells and those rows, you can do it. First go to any part of the sheet and then click Ctrl G from keyboard. Now click on special and then blanks. So the blanks will be automatically selected in your sheet. Now if you want to delete all the rows, then press Ctrl minus and select entire row and click on OK. You can see these all rows have been deleted where product name was missing. Groups and subtotal. If you have the big sheet and very large data and you want to see those data in the summarized format, you can do this with group function. Right now we have very small table, but we will apply the group function on this table. But definitely the main purpose and main objective of the group function for the large data. So let's apply grouping here. First we will select the table and then data, and in data you can go and click on the group. As we have the data in row format, means we are reading from the row point of view, like sale agent name, product name, total units sold. So we will click on the rows. So group is added. Now we need to add subtotal. We want to see the subtotal of total sale agent wise. So from here we can leave it as it is sale agent. Otherwise you can also try product and other options if you have. So let's sale agent. Now you can see summary is ready and also it group. So what is the advantage? If you will click here on outline options, so you can see in the summarized format. And if you want to change the color for more good preview, and also change the font. Now if I want to see band total is there, but what are the band products? So I can click here and can I see the products. Okay, then close. Then I want to see Gary for products and this is the information. Okay, so if I want to see all, I will just click here and collapse all. And here I can see grand total. Highlight duplicate values in Excel. So if you are working in Excel and you want to know that which records are duplicated based on any column, so you can do this in Excel. Suppose we want to know this is our column product and how many products are repeated in here in this column. So just click on the column, home, conditional formatting, highlight, duplicate values. So you can change the color, but we want to keep here the default color. Otherwise, whatever color you want, you can give. So these are the duplicate values, because one is coming here, one is coming here. 21, 21, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40 come in 4 times, and 20. So if you want to filter this record and you want to analyze why they are coming duplicate, what is the reason, go to filter and apply the filter data and then select the filter by color. So these are the duplicate records. Highlight row column based on logic or condition. If you want to present your data to highlight some figures or some records, you can automatically, you can do this with the conditional formatting. We will take the example of total sale, where total sale is less than 30,000. We want to highlight those cases. So let's go. First select this column. And then go to conditional formatting, new rule. We have many options. Format all cells based on their values. Format only cells that contain. So we will use this option, that contain. And between, you can also apply between option. Cell value is between 0 to 30,000, or you can use the less than option as well. So we'll use the less than option. If it is less than 30,000, change the background color. Alright, and bold. Okay. So let's see if any record is there. Yes, this one, this. 5-6 records are there with less than 30,000. So if you want to filter, you can also filter these records based on the color. There are many other options out there. So let's apply another one here on product column, home, conditional formatting, new rule. So specific text containing. Now instead of cell value, we are selecting specific text, because in product we have text value and that contain. You can give any word, or we will give 22. So wherever the product number 22 is coming, we want to highlight those with green. Okay. So only one product is appearing as a 22. Get a unique list or remove duplicate. Excel gives you one option to remove the duplicate records by one click. We have one table here, and there are a few duplicate records already exist in this table, and we want to remove this. So how can we do this? Go to data, remove duplicates. By default, it will select all the columns, and based on the all columns, it will remove the duplicate records. Means the product, unit cost, total cost, unit sale, total sale, VAT, value exclusive of tax, plant, amount, all fields are same, Excel will remove the duplicate records. Let's see. Okay, 13 duplicate values found from 56 unique values remains. So now we have only these 56 records. Now sort on this column product, and we can see we have the duplicate products somehow. I also want to remove the duplicate products and just want to have the one record of the each product. So how can we do this? Go to again duplicate, unselect all, and just select the product. Based on product, remove the duplicate. 13 more records have been deleted. So now we have one record for product 1, and there's no more duplicate products are appearing in this list.
Split a cell by diagonal line to get two headers. We have headers for products here, products, and these are the products, and this is the header. For quarters, we don't have headers, so let's add the header for quarters, but within one cell instead of on the top. So this is the products. Quarters. And press Alt Enter. Then right click, format cell, and add the line here, diagonal line. Now you need to add some spaces here so it will adjust the heading accordingly. This is how you can get the diagonal line and two header within one cell. Create named ranges from data. Another beauty of Excel. If you are working with large volume data set and there are many ranges, you can give them name to use in formula instead of select every time. Let's see how can we give name to ranges. Here we have one table with quarterly sale information. I want to give name to each quarter range. Select range and press Ctrl Shift F3 from keyboard. So this small window will open with the selection of name Q1 as well, top row. Press OK. Another one, Ctrl Shift F3 and press OK. Third one, another method to give the name, you can give name here, Q3 sale. And fourth, you can go to formula, create from selection, top row. You can also give the name from here. So now four ranges have been created. Now I will use them in the formula. We will use a simple formula, sum bracket Q1 first range, Q2 second range, comma Q3 third range, comma Q4 bracket close. So you can see the sum is matching with the sum. So I have used the ranges name. Underscore is coming because we have Q column as well. So Q instead Excel will automatically add the underscore to distinguish column from the range name. If you want to delete the range, just go to name manager and here you can edit or delete. Just click delete, so it will be deleted. Now here error is coming before we have deleted the range. Fix the value with dollar sign in a formula. In Excel, we put dollar sign in a cell reference to keep it fixed when we copy a formula in rows or columns. Here we have one sheet, and in this sheet we have two tables. In first table, we have the total sale USD currency wise, and we want to see the same sale in ASD currency. We have the exchange rate here, so let's apply the formula. Click on column G equal, give the reference D3, multiply with exchange rate. Now drag to last cell. So we have noticed in first cell it is calculated perfect, but in other cells the reference of the second exchange rate is getting changed. K5. So we want to fix it. Just click from mouse or type F2 from keyboard. Move the cursor before K and press F4 key from keyboard. Now press enter, drag again. So now all cells have been calculated perfectly and the reference is not getting changed. As we are working in the column, so if you are working in the column, you can remove the dollar sign before a column reference, because column will not get changed if you are working from top to bottom column reference. Now in the same way, we want to calculate the sale in AD quarterly. So come here, multiply this USD sale to dollar K and 1. Here we did not press the F4 key, we just entered manually. You can also direct enter the dollar sign, and we also did not enter the dollar sign after K. It means before number, because now we will drag the formula in row direction. So when you are dragging the formula in the row direction, only the column supposed to be fixed. Row number is not required to be fixed if you are working in the row. Let's try. So now reference is okay, here reference is okay, here reference is okay. Snap object or pictures to cell border. So how can we adjust the picture to fit in cell? First let's add one column, product picture, then go to insert picture, add one picture from your computer, and then keep press alt key from the keyboard. So when you will press alt key, we can automatically fix this picture into our cell. Right now it is out of the cell and it is very hard to manually adjust. So from alt it is very easy. Just press alt from keyboard and then with mouse left key you can adjust here, here, this one, and then the left one. See, so it is adjusted automatically. If you want to give the border to this picture, just double click, and here you can give the border black color. Create a simple Gantt chart using conditional formatting. With conditional formatting, we can create the Gantt chart. We have one table here with five activities, start date 1st March and date 20 March. So first we will add the dates here in top row, 1, 2, 3, 20, and then add lines, make it center. Now we already have the formula here. By using this formula we will apply the condition. If you are not able to get this formula how it is working, you can ask in the comments, or I have also explained in my another video. So click on the first cell, conditional formatting, click here, it is in the home tab, new rule, use a formula to determine which cell to be formatted, and paste the formula here and use any color, whatever color you want to use the blue color. Okay, okay, so first cell is selected. Now drag this cell to the last column and then again drag to last row. So simple Gantt chart is created. first March to 5th March, then 6 to 8, then 9 to 13, 14 to 16, and the last 20.
Evaluate a formula step by step.
We have two values here. A is 1, B is 2, and then formula. It results coming yes. How it coming yes? Let's go to formula tab and click here, evaluate formula. So now you can see the reference. Click on the next step, evaluate. The first result is coming 1. The second is coming 2. So 1 is less than 2. Yes, 2. If formula will give us the result, 2. Answer is yes. Because in if formula, once the answer, the logic is condition is true, then always the second part is executed. And in second part, yes is written. We also have one big formula here. And we created this Gantt chart based on this formula in conditional formatting here. So it is automatically adjusting the color of different dates. Now we will apply the formula and see how it is working here. Paste, drag to last column. And then last row. Okay. Here it is coming true, 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 true. That's why background color change. But here it's coming false. So let's evaluate first true value. Formula. Evaluate. So first column D5. And then D5. It's 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0. Then B5 minus B5. In the B5 we have the date, and here Excel is giving the serial number of date. It cannot give the date format directly. So it's 0. 0 is equal to 0. Condition true. Fine. The next one, column D5 and D5. So this is again 0. And the next one, C5 minus B5. So what is the result coming? 4. 4. 0 is less than 4. 2. In the AND operator, if both conditions are true, then the result is true. So first one is true. Now here false. Why it is coming false? Let's see. Evaluate formula. Evaluate 5. How it is coming 5? Because column is selected 5, D5 to H6. So column formula give us the total number of columns. From D5 to H5, total number of columns are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 minus 1, 4. The next one is B6 minus B5. This is the B6 and the previous date is B5. So 6 minus 1 is again 5. Let's see. Yeah, 5. 4 is greater than 5. First condition is false. Now no need to evaluate the next condition, because in the AND operator, if first condition is false, then the result is false. Let's see. Evaluate, evaluate. False. So here it's giving us false state. This is how you can evaluate the formula in Excel. Find and replace partial matches. Normally, if you want to replace any text in Excel, it will only replace that part of text. However, if you want to replace text with full word, that is also possible. Now we are in one sheet and we can see starting 5 characters of these all 6 words are same. So let's replace with initial 5 characters. Restore. We will replace with the restart. Replace all. So it actually only replaces the given part. Restore with restarts. back. If you will give the static here, then wherever the restore text is coming in the words, it will be replaced with the full word restart. Let's see. Restart it says. So with static, you can replace the part of text with the full word. Put a comment in Excel formula. Sometimes we put a comment in the formula for own usage, that what is the reason behind this formula and why we are creating the formula, or any type of other comments we can put in the formula. Here we have one calculated column here, where we are actually calculating the total sale in other currency. Here it is in the USD and we are calculating in AED, and exchange rate is here. So we just add the comment here, and operator n, and in the bracket, then inverted comma, whatever you want to add the comment. I will say here exchange rate of 1st January, and then just drag it. So here you can see everything is same, only comments are appearing in the formula. So it will not display. Even if you want to display, you can do it. How? Just remove the n. So you can see comments are now appearing, but with n, and actually hide the comments. Display negative value in red using number formatting. If you have some negative numbers in your data and you want to present them as a red highlighted color, you can also do this with the formatting. So let's go to format cell, custom 0.0 semicolon, and then bracket red closed semicolon 0 minus 0.0. So click OK. This is the way you can display the negative numbers as red highlighted. Insert picture into a comment box. We have few products here and we want to display the picture of this product. So just right click, insert comment, remove the name, and then click on the edge or border of box, format comments. Then we have here color and lines. Just right click, fill effects, picture, select picture. We have products here, so let's see. This is product one. Okay. Okay. So whenever we will click on the product one, we can see this is the product one. Display number as a text using number formatting. We have here few numbers and we want to display one of the number as a text. Suppose we just click the data, format, custom, and here bracket equal to, first we will zero, select the zero, then in the inverted comma you have to write not for sale. Okay, so you can see wherever the zero is there, it is mentioned not for sale. Okay, and if you want to change for any other number, like we have 1 200, so we can change here low sale or less than 200 ton. So if it is less than 200, then low sale. But this is suppose we change the quantity to 1.5, so low sale. Format large numbers in millions or billions. So we have here one table with total sale. So just select the numbers. This is sum of all numbers. Format custom hash dot hash 2 times comma space and then type M. M means million. But we want to display the last total sale as billion. So just click here in the custom format and add one more comma. And instead of M, put B. So in this way, you can display large numbers, million or billions. Intersect operator in Excel. Intersect operator in Excel is method of finding the intersected cell or cells within two cell ranges. Now we will try to find the intersect value of this table. So how can we do? Just click equal, give the value of first range. Then you have to give the space and then second range. Just click enter. So it will find the intersect value. You can also find the intersect value for more than one ranges. How? Just select these two ranges and then just select these two ranges and then space, then these two ranges. Here error is coming, so just click F2 or double click for mouse and press Ctrl Shift Enter. And then because we have found first value, so just drag to right side, as we know there are four values, and then drag to down, so all values are coming here, all intersect values. Convert column format type from number to string or string to number, whatever we want. Sometimes for data analysis and other method, we want to compare our records. And if it is in the number format, we convert into the string, or if it is in the string format, we convert into a number. Suppose we have here count number. Right now it's coming as a number. So how can we convert into string? There are two methods. First, select all numbers, Control C, and paste in the notepad. How can you say select all numbers? Shift Control and down key and then Control C. Change the format to text. Right now it is journal, so text, and still it is number, so just copy Control. Now this is actually converted into the text. Another method, suppose we have here unit sold. This is also number and we want to change into the string. So just select them all. Data, convert text to column. Just click next and then remove the any check from here. Again next. Here you can give the format text. Click finish. So this is again converted into the text. So if you want to convert number to text, you can do it like this way. If you want to convert text to number, you can use the notepad as well. Now we will change number. Control C, paste here, Control C, and then paste again here. Click OK. So now it is converted again into the number. Work with imported data. Sometimes you receive the file in Notepad or some other formats which is not in Excel format, and you want to convert them into columns or rows. How you can do, let's see. We have this data. We will just select all, Control C, and paste here. Now we want to have this data into different columns. So just select, go to data, text to columns. Now click characters such as commas or tabs separate each field, yes. And then select how you want to separate or how you want system to analyze. This is new field. Here we can see our data is separated with comma. So you can select the comma, or if you have any special character, you can type here. So we will select the comma. Next. Now if any date is there, you can change the format to date, or if you want to change the format to text, you can select text. But we don't have any date. If date column suppose was there, then we should have click on that column from here and then check date, but we don't have right now. So just journal, finish. Have you noticed this is our data now converted into different four columns? How to use VLOOKUP function? One of the best feature of Excel when we want to bring data in a sheet from another sheet based on any key column. The VLOOKUP function has four parts. We have one cell here, press equal, VLOOKUP. First part is lookup value, what you want to look up. Second, where you want to look for it. Third, the column number in the range containing the value to return. Fourth, return an approximate or exact match. So we want to bring the division head name from the another sheet. This is our another sheet. Here's the account number and who is the responsible person or division head. So let's bring this division head here based on this account number. We can go and find manually, but Excel give us the VLOOKUP formula, so we will apply this formula. Equal VLOOKUP, this value B2, give the reference comma, we want to search in this list, select all column from the header. If you will select all column from the headers, our sheet will remain same. It will not change the values of references. Otherwise, if you will give the reference of only table, then you have to enter the dollar sign. So it's better to give the all columns, select from top, and also keep the key column on the most left side. Okay, you cannot keep this key column on the right side and then search for the division. Keep the column on the left side. If it is on the right side, just move on the left side. Now B2 value, system will search the B2 value here and it will return the division head name. So comma, this is 1, 2, column number 3, comma, and exact match 0, false. So remaining formula we can enter here in the header because we want to see column numbers and every information. So we can enter here. It will automatically go back to previous sheet when we will press enter. So exact match 0, bracket close, press enter. Now we back to our main sheet and just drag the formula. So it will automatically copy all the division head names in this sheet based on this first column. This is how you can use the VLOOKUP formula in Excel. How to use VLOOKUP formula for multiple columns? We have already seen how can we use the VLOOKUP formula, and we have applied on the division head. Now we want to apply the VLOOKUP formula in column I. So let's apply the formula and bring the unit information from here. So VLOOKUP reference account comma, select the range, all these four columns, then comma 1, 2, 3, 4, column number 4, and exact match 0. Just drag it. So you will notice here that for product 2, even it is coming zone A, but in our another sheet for product 2 we have zone B. So how can we bring the zone B there? So let's remove this formula and first add one key column in this sheet and in that sheet. So what is the key column? Key join these two ranges B and C. B2 AND operator C2 and drag it. So this key column is ready and now values are unique. Go to here. We also have to add key column here. B2 and A2 and B2. Now we will add the based on this key column I2 comma range. So we will select only these two columns. You can select all 5, 6 columns, but it's okay, just select two columns. And keep in mind, always keep your key column on the left side. And comma, this as per our selection range DE, this is column 2 now, 2, because we did not select all 5 columns. Comma, exact match 0, and then drag it. So now for product 2, we can see zone B is coming. Just convert these two into values. Control C and paste values. Because when we will delete the formula column, key column, it will get disturbed. So it is better first convert into the values and then delete the column. Now you can delete from here. Create simple query in Excel. If you are data analyst and you mostly extract the data from any data source, so this is one of the good feature when you can write the query within Excel and connect to a database and extract the data from database. How can we do this? In my case, I will only connect to Excel database because right now I don't have any database like Oracle or Microsoft SQL Server in my machine. So I have created one ODBC connection with Microsoft Access database. Let's connect to that one. Go to data tab. Here from other source, here you can connect from SQL Server and you can connect to any other source. I will go for this one from Microsoft Query, import data through ODBC. Here I have one connection data. Okay. I have two tables and one query, so I will just add the first table. That's it. Here in wizard we can mention that any condition if you want to mention like date. Okay, date is less than, we can say okay, 2005 November. Okay, sort column if you want to give, it's up to you. Next, if you want to directly edit the query, you can directly edit, but first we will display some results and then we will also edit the query. So cell is automatically selected. First cell, you can select the another cell, it's up to you. We will start from second cell. Okay, so here we have the data from query. All data have been downloaded from database into our Excel. Now we have the data only for 2004 and before. So I will go to data, connection, properties, definition, and here I can edit the query. Here you can see I mentioned 2005. So let's mention 2010 and check again. Okay. Go to data, reverse. Yes, we have 2007 records now. Before we didn't have. Now here we have the status, urgent, normal, emerge. Now go again, connection, properties, definition. If you are good with the query, you can write the query here. Otherwise, click edit query and you can do this task with the wizard as well. If you will click here. But I will write the query here. Where date, log date to be less than 2010 and status equal to urgent, and also I change the date just for, I think I don't have data, so urgent, only urgent, and still 2007 data is coming.
3D sum in Excel. Excel allows us to sum the same cell ranges on the multiple worksheet by using the sum function with 3D reference. So same cell ranges means your worksheet structure should be same on all the sheets. Here we have three sheets, 2018, 17, 19 sales data, and the total value is coming in the column E11. So it is same in every sheet, the reference is same. Now if reference is same, you can use the 3D formula in summary. How can we use the 3D reference? Click equal, sum, give the name of first sheet, which is 2017, and give the reference of last sheet, 2019. It will also automatically consider the all the sheets which is coming between 2017 and 19. So if you have data from 2010 to 2020, you just give the first reference and last reference, other sheets will be automatically calculated. Now exclamation sign and reference E11. So here we can see that it is sum of is coming of all three sheets. I have already
copied values here
to just show you it is matching. Instead of sum, you can also use the other formulas like average. So it will show you the average of 3 years. Sum if function. We use the sum if function to sum the values in a range that meet criteria that we specify. For example, we have one sheet here and we already have the sum of total sale here. Now within this range, we want to know what is the John's total sales figure. So we are coming here, we will apply the formula sum if. First one, sum if s, we will see later. Bracket, range, on what range we want to use the logic. So this is the range. And what is the answer of this range? Then system will calculate the sum, John. In inverted comma, you have to type the John, then comma. Then select the range which you want to sum. So this range we want to sum. So it is coming 133746. And if I will select these values, then it is matching 133746. So this is the total sale of John. This is how we can use the sum if formula based on some conditions. Now I want to know the John sales only of priority low, where it says it's low. So how can I do this? Equal sum if s. In sum if, we can only use the one condition or one range for criteria checking, but in sum if s, we can use the multiple criteria ranges. But here we have to give the sum range first instead of the criteria range like we did in the sum if formula. So first give the sum range, then you can use the n number of criteria. So first criteria is John. We will use this range, comma, type John. Then another range, priority, comma, then in the inverted comma we have to say low. Then if you want to give one additional range, you can give for checking, but we are giving only two ranges, so bracket close. So for low, for this value and this value, the sum is 87,846. Count, count A, count if, and count if S function in Excel. These four functions actually count the number of cells in Excel, but every function have little different behavior. So let's start with count. First count function actually only counts the number. If your column has the numbers, then it will count. If it has the text, it will not return any value. So first we will use count bracket. I can show you, I just put this string, so no value. Now I will use the count and use this numbers, so 12. Now I will use count A. Count A and count, only the difference, count A actually counts the string 12. Count with one criteria. Now we want to count how many products sold by John. So count if, we have to give equal sign, bracket, range. This is the range we want to count. And what is the criteria? Criteria John. Just count when John is coming. Four times. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, four times. Next one is count if S. In count if S, actually you can give the multiple criteria. In count if function, you can give only one criteria. So now we will give multiple criteria in this function. Count if S criteria range. So first one, first this criteria, comma, inverted comma, John, inverted comma close, and then sold quantity range, comma, what is the criteria here? Sold quantity should be more than 50. How many times John sold more than 50 units? This is the total count, 2. So let's see, first time John sold 66, second time 45. 45 does not meet our logic. Again 66 and again 45. So 2 times 45 is coming. If I will just change the value to 66, you can see here figure is changed. Enter bullets in Excel. How can we enter the bullets in Excel? We have a few products here. Just click, double click, and from keyboard press Alt+7, leave it, and Alt+7 and Alt+8, Alt+9. So this is how you can enter the bullets in Excel. If you want to enter in any empty bullet, you can also do, just press F2 from keyboard, enter in the cell, then Alt+7 or Alt+9. This is how you can enter the bullet. Text manipulation functions. We have some functions which we use mostly in our Excel sheet to play with the text and to use the text in required formats. So we have here some formulas: left, length, repetition, right, trim, upper, lower. How can we use? So first one will actually return you the left characters, whatever length you will give. So we apply here equal reference of the cell C4 and return 9 character. So in the second part we have to guess how many character it will return. So 9 character, actually it is returning the Microsoft. Second one is length. In the length we have to give the reference again C5. It will return the length of the string 16. Repeat Rep function actually repeats the text. So how many times you want to repeat, you have to give. I want to repeat 3 times. So it will repeat the Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Excel. And then write function actually returns the number of characters from right side. So we want to return 5 characters. We have one space here, so that's why it was counting the space as a number. Please also note this one, because sometimes you have the spaces and you cannot see. So to remove the space, what is the best option? Next function, trim. Trim actually will remove the spaces from your text. So suppose if we have the space here, we can use the trim function within write function. Trim and then text C7. So now it will return the Excel regardless we have the spaces, because we use the trim function within the write function. That you can also do with other functions as well. Function within function. Next one is upper and lower. So this text is already upper. We will apply the lower function first. Lower and give the reference C9. It will convert into the lower. And if text is already lower, then use upper function. So it will convert the text to upper text. Import data from web. If you want to download any data from any website, you can also directly download in Excel. Here we have one website and we want to download the stock trends from that website. So just go to data tab, from web, paste the address here. We have addresses, let's copy, paste, go to. Now we have here 4 tables. Wherever you will see the table, a arrow automatically will appear there. So we have arrow here. Now I want to download only top trending. So just click here and click on the import and keep the cell reference here where you want to download. Okay. So automatically top trend will be downloaded here. So whatever you want to download from any website, you can just go and click on the table and data will be downloaded in Excel. Reduce the file size in Excel. One of the most required trick. If you have very big size file and cannot attach to email, you want to reduce the file size without the help of any other software, you can do in Excel. How? We have this very big large data file, and the size of this file is almost 30 MB. Now we want to reduce the file size. How can we do? Just open go to file, save as, then select the option Excel binary workbook and save it. So have you noticed the file size has been reduced to 7.5 MB? There's no issue if you want to save the file in binary. Reference to an area in a worksheet. If you are working in a sheet and you want to give the reference of another sheet, you can give by hyperlink. We are in this worksheet and we want to add the hyperlink here in the account. Whenever I will click on account, I will jump to another sheet. Let's see how. Go to hyperlink and here you have the options. You want to give the reference in any other book, or you want to give the reference of the same workbook. We want to give the reference within the same workbook placed in this document, and then you have to select the sheet. So I will give to the
sheet 14.1. Okay, so now link is added here, and whenever I will click on the link, system will automatically jump to the sheet number 14-1. So if you want to show any detail of anything and the details is available in any another sheet, you can just add the reference, and by clicking on the reference you can jump to that sheet. Display columns header as number instead of alphabets. This how you can do. Just go to File, Options, Formulas, and here you can give the R1C1 reference styles. By clicking on this one, you can see instead of alphabet, it will show the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Get camera tool in Excel. This is required for screen clipping. So how can we add this? Let's see. File, then Options, Quick Access Toolbar, Commands not in the ribbon, and here you have the camera. Just add the camera here on the right side, click on the camera and just click on the add button. Okay, so it is added on the top. Now if I will select the table and click on camera, so picture is already took. Now I can paste here. So you can see this is now picture, and the same picture copy I can paste in paint brush. Grouping and ungrouping sheets. In Excel workbook, if you have too many sheets and you want to change the color of all those sheets, and if you want to hide all sheets, if you want to delete all sheets, you can group them and you can perform this task with one click. So how can we group them? Just click from left mouse key and keep pressing control key from keyboard. So control and left mouse, these all three have been selected. Now I can hide them, I can move them. So first I will change the color. Let's change the color, and then I will move them to right side after sheet 7. So also you can delete whatever function you want to do, and you can ungroup them as well. Ungroup sheets. Locate a keyboard shortcut. In Excel, if you don't want to use mouse and you want to work only with keyboard, it is possible and very easy. Suppose we want to change the background color of this table, but we are not using the mouse. Just select all cells, shift and arrow keys, with the help of arrow keys, then press Alt. When you will press the Alt, you will see shortcuts will appear. So okay, then H home, then again I just want to show you these are the characters. Now I want to change the background, so instead of mouse I will press the H key again, and then I can change the background of cell colors. So I want to select green and I will press Enter, so it is selected. So just press Alt and check which option you want. Menu, you can see characters. So you want to take the picture 5, just press 5 and then Enter. So picture has been taken. Auto recover information every X minutes. Auto recovery option help us to protect our workbooks from unexpected computer crashes or power failure. However, if we want to be more secure in case of a crash or electricity failure, we should lower the time interval for saving information. The more frequently the document is saved, the more versions we have, the more chances to get all the changes back. Let's go to File, Options, and Save. So by default it's always automatically tick, and with 10 minutes interval means you can get the data of last 10 minutes or more, but you cannot get the data if it is your file get crashed in last 9 minutes. So just lower the value. We lower the value to 3 if you are working on very important data. If you will make it 1 or 2, definitely your computer will create the more versions, so it will also take some processing time. So better keep it 3 or 5 and click OK. So now we have the more chances to get our file back or recover in case of any crash or failure. Hide ribbon. If you want to work on your Excel sheet and you want to see this worksheet area little big, you can hide this ribbon. How? Just right click here and collapse the ribbon. So now this worksheet area has been increased. If you want to bring the ribbon, just click here one time and it comes back. Just remove this tick. So ribbon is back. Customizing the ribbon. If you want to have your own tab here with most frequently used options, then you can add it. How? Just right click here, customize the ribbon, and then new tab. Just rename the tab name. Daily usage. And then here, whatever you want to create the group, you can create. So rename main, then SQL. In the main you can now add whatever option you want to add here. Just like home font, so I add font here, and then in SQL data connections, and add connections. Okay, so this is my daily work. And here I can see I have added the connection and font. So whatever options you want to add, you can make your own customized menu and ribbon, and accordingly you can add the different options. Open Excel templates. If you want to design a report or you want to design a format of any document, you can use the Excel templates. You can take the help of Excel templates instead of you will design or start from the scratch. How can we add the template? Just go to File, New. Here are many templates are there. You can also see more categories. I have clicked on the business. The business sales element. I want to add the invoice format as invoice template. It's actually searched on the web, so you have to be connected with the internet. Sample invoice. So I will just add the sample invoice. Create. So here it is added. Now you can change your company name. You can change the currency format. Whatever you want to change, you can change it. So this is how we can add the templates. Now we will add one more template of inventory with highlights. So this is added here. This is by default data is there, but you can also add your own data and you can change the logo, company name, headings, whatever you option want. Get the developer tab displayed in Excel ribbon. By default, developer tab is not available in top menu. If you want to add, you have to go to File, Options, Customize Ribbon, and click here. So once you will click here and click OK, so it will be added here. Now if you want to perform any macro or want to add any code, you can add from here. write a small macro in Excel. So let's add one button here. Click on new. Here we will type the code. So we want to change the background color of cell A1. Range, cell reference number, interior color, this is one of the color, and that's it. Just close it. So press this button, you can see the color is changed. Right click and change the button name, change the color of cell. Now add one more button. New, just copy this command and change the color back to 0. Change the color of cell to white. This is how you can add. In third one, new message box, and just select this statement. We want to see what is the color number. So copy from here and just paste here. This is area is the module, whatever coding required for the VBA, we enter here. So edit text, color number. Whenever I will click on this button, Excel will display a message, number of the color 37. Enable macros. Whenever we open the enabled macro workbook, we have noticed one message appears on our top of the worksheet area that enable content. If we will not enable it, our macros will not work. So why every time this message is coming and how can we avoid this? Go to File, Options, Trust Center Setting, Macros, Enable All Macros. Not recommended if you are opening the file, enabled macro files, downloading from internet. Definitely if something dangerous code is written there, it can harm your computer. But if you are using your own design file, then there's no issue to enable this button. So just click OK, OK, and OK. So next time when you will open this file, this message will not come.